Hi everyone and welcome back. So here we are talking about writing clean code, and what I will do is I will start with variable naming. So we should always take care about naming conventions, right? Like whatever the naming we are doing for the variables which we are using in our application, we should always take care of that. Either you use a let or const, that is based on what you are doing currently. If you are actually creating some const object, then always use const, or if the value is getting changed, then use let for that. Okay, so consider that sometimes what we do is let time equal to, and then you what we do is new date, and we specify the date, which is 2020 comma 1 comma 1, something like this, right? So consider this is a time, and then you all other you have another variable which is also time 1, right? And these times you are using as the arrival time and departure time. Then instead of just putting this time and time 1, will it not be a good of using arrival time? I mean, this will give us a clean understanding about okay, this is arrival time and this is the departure time. So while giving a variable name, we use this kind of a camel case signature, and don't use just XYZ capital object or something like this. So while creating the object, we simply create an object, something like this. But what this object is actually talking about, we should create something like this const user, because here we are talking about user, and user has all these properties like name and address. So this name of the object itself will tell us what properties we are adding, what all these properties are associated to this user object, not a simple object or something else, right? Similarly, like you can have another object like order, and where you have, instead of putting like, consider you are putting order ID, order number, right? Now, instead of this, we already know that you are adding a properties for this particular order. It can be simple order ID, and if you have a number, then you can add a number, right? Or you can also say order ID, order tracking, if you want a tracking for this number or not, right? So this object signifies what you are storing. Then you don't need to specifically put order ID here. We already know that you're talking about order, so it can be simply order ID. It will be simply ID. Okay, this is about how you are creating the objects, how you are creating the naming of variables, naming of functions. So the name of the function should itself tell us what we are doing it, because function will execute something, right? Like if I talk about simple factorial, there is no issue with this factorial function. What it is doing, it is going to return as factorial of a particular number. If I just pass n, so it can be a simple number. And here if I will be checking if number equal to 0 or number equal to 1, then I will return 1. Otherwise, what we can do is return n multiplied by, I will just calling this factorial function recursively. Now here we don't need to write else block or something. It's understood, okay, if this is not going into this, if it is going into this block, then it will execute it, it will not come here. So if it is executing this if block, nothing happens, then obviously it will execute this return block. You don't need to write explicit else block. Here factorial function looks good, but if we want to make it more specific, get factorial of number. This is like more clear what we are doing in this particular function, right? This function is taking a number as an input, and it is giving us, and don't accept a lot of arguments. Okay, number 1, number 2, number 3. Your function should be as small as possible. It should not be taking n number of arguments as an input. Your function name itself tells us what the function is doing. Okay, so function name should be good enough to understand what the functionality that function can have. Okay, apart from that, sometimes we write classes like class student, and then we add a constructor most of the time, and then we assign the variables, right? So here also sometimes we do the same mistake, is we start creating the variables. Here we have student name, student ID, and you don't need to write something like this kind of code, because here we are repeating something. If you just see what we are repeating in this example, is we are repeating the student word most of the time, right? Just finish the student name, and you are actually assigning student name to this, and you have some methods, something like this, get student, and you might be returning something. For now I will just put null, and then you can say save student. Some functions like this, right? So what common wrong thing we are doing here is we are repeating one word, right? This student class, we already know that this represents a student, so we don't need to repeat these student keyword. It can have a simple ID, name ID, and address, and we can assign those variables, right? This can be a simplified way of writing it. And get student, right? So we don't need to specify the entity, we are already inside a student class, so we know what we are accessing. So it can be a simple get method, it can be a simple save or insert or update, anything. You don't need to write update. So these methods should simplify very easily. Like if you are creating the object student equal to new student, and you should use the linters which should identify the mistakes you are doing. Student dot now, here we can actually get all these methods, simply get, right? And simply student dot, this is an object, so we can actually save, update. These are the methods directly we are calling on student. It means we are trying to update a student, we are trying to get a student. These method name explicitly telling us what these methods are doing. We don't need to call save student, get student, all these things. Okay, this is about our first video, that we don't need to, whenever we are creating objects, we don't need to repetitively use that objective of that object in each and every property. Same with the classes and same with the variables. Okay, thanks everyone.